Hi, Pep. You said how impressed you are with Burnley, having watched them. Have you watched them before preparing for this game? No. Have you seen them before the season?
No, we saw a game against United when playing Carabao Cup, I think so, yeah. But it was time ago. So since then, I think it changed a little bit the way they play. But his variation. So he made many, many good movements. It depends sometimes if we're in the back, three in the back, sometimes in diamonds, sometimes a structure 3-2, sometimes the fullbacks inside they have. It's so difficult to understand what they're going to do because you cannot control everything because you don't know exactly what they have to do. But the movement they do always have sense. Every single action. and you realize when you see them, there is work behind. There's a good knowledge and that's why what I said about Beanie, I think sooner or later going to come here, not because he was an important figure as a football player that helps, or the connection with the fans, or knowing the club and the Premier League that is important. Is that I'm talking about, he understands the game, he knows exactly. And I have a rumor that he's an incredible work ethic and he's a guy like all the club put pressure in every department to do it the best. And when you combine your knowledge about the game for experience and after your love for the club that you love, so at the end, these kind of things, you know, must to finish together.
And how much more impressive does it make what he's done? The fact that he walked into a club that had just been relegated.
Yeah.
They sold almost their entire team from the Premier League.
Yeah.
And brought in players for about 2/3 of the money that they brought in.
Listen, the results they have done so far, with this consistency in the Champions League, I can imagine how tough it must be. And being, I don't know, 17, 18 points in front of the second or the third, I don't know exactly, but, you know, incredible advantage to go. But especially the way they play is because there is something there. There is something there. So we are going to play against team like this Premier League team. Almost already. I know Beanie maybe that don't like to listen to this because I always have to be cautious as a manager. I would do the same because as it is done, it's not done. But we have to talk about this, a Premier League team. And when it's quarterfinals, FA Cup and everything can happen, you have to, you know, have to be careful. But this amount of good results week in, week out is because you have something. Otherwise, you cannot be this type of consistent for a long time if there is not work behind or something like it's solid. You know, because always bad afternoons you have and bad moments, but it doesn't happen. It happens because the result, after result, after result is winning, 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 winning. And that means there are a lot of work on the pitch and a lot behind the scenes.
You talked a little bit about how important Vinny was off the field here. We all know, we could all see how important he was on the field. Are there any moments that you think back on, you think of him making a major difference off the field? Any particular moments?
When we're together?
Yes.
Yeah, many, many times. Many times I had problems, always there. So I think he understood perfectly the role of captain and he applied really well. So there are many, many things, of course. And the guy was, unfortunately, was injured quite often, but always would recover. And after 1 week, he was ready to play and he didn't feel the pressure. He was there. I said, I'm going to play, but unfortunately was, you know, he knows it. Otherwise, he was already a legend. Imagine being consistent in terms of not injuries in the last period. It will be even more.
Okay. Since João Cancelo left, it would be easy to think there's not many options in the defence. And recently you've been playing the four centre-backs, but there is a lot of options because obviously Stones goes into midfield. You've had Bernardo at left back, Ake kind of on the left back as well. How have you managed since João left to find these different changes, and what impact do you think they've had on the team? Or does it have an impact going forward? Like, has it helped Jack? Has it helped find Erling? These kind of things?
The same. I imagine the same when he was here. So in the build up with back three, suit perfect for the players that we have. If we need, for example, to play with a fullbacks wide up and down, so like 95% or 99% of the teams they play in that way, we cannot do it. We don't have players to do this right now. So we don't have fullbacks who go up and down every 3 days. Oh my God. We don't have this this quality. So we have to adapt, but the same happened with George. With him, we lost a little bit deeper. He could play a little bit more there. But with the players that we have right now, with Ford, at, for example, Kyle or Aime, suit perfect the way we are making building up with three in the back or four and after two and three or whatever. So we can do it. It's not, the impact was, have not been absolutely important.
I know you say you don't think too much about the transfer market, but generally, when it comes to buying players this summer, do you want the kind of players you don't have?
Yeah.
Like, okay, so you want to add that variety.
Yeah. It's so important for the future, yeah.
Is that defence, wing, midfield,
yeah.
Yeah. Everywhere?
We need some... Yeah, we need, yeah.
And seeing as there's not many people here, can I ask you a more general question? You play against teams quite a lot that sit back, maybe five-man defence, three men in midfield, and that's really difficult. What do you think, as a coach, is the best way to combat teams like that? Like, what are the best way for your team with the players you've got?
Have 10 Haalands and score 5 goals, everyone. That is the best tactic.
He doesn't do that every game, though. So how do you get the ball to him five times to score a goal?
I put the ball there, and we'll score. So that is the best tactic. So the quality of the players, they make tactic is the players. The players, his form, his feet, his... what they have to do, that is the best. The rest is in the numbers that they move and try to help them what you have to do, but at the end is the quality of the players.
I wanted to ask about Ruben Dias. He seems to have found his best form again and really seems to be kind of having a big impact on everyone around him in the team. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, absolutely. He's a type of player quite similar to Vinny's. How, it's not about how I play myself, you know. Ruben is not playing just his game, he's playing the game for everyone. And oh, it's my player, you know, his ability to see and solve the problems from many things. His character is so important in tactics. When you talk about tactics, this is incredible, another part of the important tactics when we talk about football. His leadership is huge, especially even when he didn't play. You should see the impact on before the game, on halftime, or even after the game when he didn't play, game by game didn't play. He behaved the same when he was playing. And that makes you deserve to be captain or deserve to be. That way we choose. It's choose. And his character and leadership is really, really, really important. Really one.
What sort of things does he do when he isn't playing? Is he still vocal in the dressing room?
Yeah, absolutely. And behaving the day after in the training and never complain and work the same methodology and work ethic, arriving 2 hours before, leaving 2 hours before, nothing changed. He lives 24 hours for his profession. But in that moment, maybe for my mistakes or not, I decide to need something specific, you know, movement or something that there are maybe players that they are a little bit better than that. But maybe it should be in a tactic aspect, in the way. But in the way, what we need in the that should play every single game. Every single game. Because it's not, like I said, not just about me or just about what they have to do. It's about what the team and always being that when the player was not happy. So nothing changed. But there are many, many things that you can help being happy to the team. And when that's happened, I said many times, when that's happened, his mate knows it. When that's happened, when you go on the pitch, always you play good. You don't have regrets for yourself. You are always positive. I know what you have done when the situation goes wrong. And always you play good.
And he's obviously very good in his own right, but the way he kind of celebrates the defensive actions that he makes, but the way the ones that his teammates make, and does that make you feel that, you know, it was very, very difficult for you to replace Vincent Kompany, but Dias has kind of brought some of those qualities?
Absolutely. The body language, the gestures, this kind of thing is so important in football. And always is, and always since the day one, have been there. Yeah, it's always positive. Next one, thinking next action, forget the mistake I've done, or miss the bad moments, always is there for the next one. It's so positive. His mentality is top of the top. That's why I can play a central defender in a top club, like Manchester City. Okay, thank you.